on her knee. She used to comb my hair. She used to tell me stories. She took me everywhere. I remember so well the best times I ever had with my grandma. Was on Saturday night, 'cause that's when you got ready to go to church on Sunday morning. And around about 7:30 or 8 o'clock, my grandma would say, "Dianne, it's time for you to take your bath." And I'd go into the bathroom. And there in the bathtub would be some nice, warm bubble bath. Now you see, my mama always had to fight with me to get in the tub. But when Grandma said it, it sounded like it was the right thing to do. And she put me in that tub. She made it so fun. She put my rubber duckies and my little frog in too, and my bubbles, and let me splash around a little while. Then she'd come in with the most beautiful hands, soft. And she would scrub me up, then rinse me off, dry me off, and grease me down, just like that. She put me in those little flannel pajamas, you know, the kind with the feet in them, even in the summertime. Catch any colds around her. Then we'd go into the bedroom and we'd kneel by the side of the bed, and that's where I learned how to say my prayers. I can hear it in my mind. Now I lay me down to sleep. Pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Then she'd put me in the bed, tuck me in, and kiss me in the middle of my forehead and say, "Child, you can be anything you want to be, 'cause God says so and Grandma says so too." And I go right to sleep, dreaming of flying. I miss those dreams. Then early in the morning, I'd be awakened by the most incredible smell you ever smelled in your life. And there on the breakfast table, would be some grits and some scrambled eggs, whatever kind of meat you wanted to prepare. But the crown and touch was on the left-hand side of the plate in a little saucer filled with alligator syrup. There would be this big, fat, flaky, buttery biscuit. And my grandma taught me how to use that biscuit like a utensil. Yes, she did. Oh, yeah. But more than the food was the conversation. You see, grandmas have a way of not talking down to the little ones.
They talk to us like we're just little people. Sometimes my grandma would have her coffee and I'd say, you know, I want some too. She'd have a cup, she'd put about that much coffee in it and a whole lot of milk, just a little sugar. And we'd sit there and sip. And when I drink coffee, I still drink it the same way, except I ask for a latte. And then miraculously, I go into the bedroom and the bed would be all made up and all my clothes would be neatly laid on the top. And my grandma said, baby, we gotta get ready to go to church. Yeah. And I'd put on my red velvet, you know, jumper, the kind with a little white shirt and a Peter Pan collar. And my white lace fold down at the ankle socks with my black patent leather T-strap shoes. My grandma would put a little Vaseline on them to make them shine. Oh, yeah. And then she'd get ready. I remember she'd put on her coat, looked like a royal robe. And she'd put that big, beautiful hat on, and in the mirror, she would just kind of cock it just right. She put a little purse on her forearm filled with lifesavers, Kleenex, and her ties. And she grabbed my little hand and say, oh, we're going to the house of the Lord. We're gonna get our hearts fixed. Whoa. Thank you so much.